the Police Foundation has provided the police department 6 UAVs. And I can't be happier with the program. We deploy with those UAVs on every tactical operation that we encounter. The foundation has bought the technology for us to remote the video from the UAVs into our command post. So myself and the other commanders associated with the Special Operations Division, we get to see all the video streaming live that's coming over.
We can push that out to the web so the commanders in the field can look at it on their phone, they can look at it in their in-car computer. Commanders can see it in their command post bus so that we can provide that situational awareness to the commander so they know what's going on the ground and they can use that information to better deploy and more efficiently deploy troops.
Up until now, we've never been able to utilize any type of overwatch if the helicopter wasn't flying, to make sure that those officers are safer when they're checking an area for a suspect.
The tactical officers would come back and draw a sketch out on a sheet of paper about how the house is laid out and where a fence may be and where a rock wall may be. Now the tactical officer, when he comes back, they can both look at the video from the UAV and they both can come up with common discussion points and common reference points of how they want to make their tactical entry to the house or make their tactical approach to that house. The foundation also bought 3D mapping software so we can take all of those photos and create a 3D model of the crime scene.
During most of our major events, like the recent World Series parade, plaza lighting, Mayor's Night Out, we utilize those tactical cameras. We place them in position so we can have real-time video watching the event the entire time. That way, if we start to see something happen, then we can address it quicker.
In the past, what we've had to do is we've had to place tactical officers on the roofs of buildings just to monitor the crowd, and then they would relay through the radio to what they are seeing. Well, with the cameras, we can place those cameras and provide that direct feed to the commander, so instead of them imagining what 100 people running to the south means, they can exactly see what's going on. And then that allows us to take those officers who are on the roof and place them on the ground nearby.
It provides an element of safety for the citizens involved in the area where these events are going off, and it also provides the officers an element of safety.
With the equipment and technology that the Police Foundation has purchased, we have built a state-of-the-art video system. We have several cities who come and visit us to see how we use our cameras and how we integrate those cameras into our daily patrol practices. We also have visitors who come from out of the country, from Paris, France, and from Brussels, who have come here to see how we're using our video system and how we've integrated it into deploying cameras in a portable fashion and for events and critical incidents.
Without the foundation buying that kind of technology, we would be light years behind the criminals.
Without the continued support and funding that comes from the Police Foundation here in Kansas City, there's no way that we would be able to, on our own, independently afford these technologies that help take these violent offenders off the street.
Good training turns into better cases, which turns into convictions, which ultimately puts people off the streets, makes our city safer, and reduces crime.
Thank you again to the donors. Without you, this wouldn't be possible. And you probably don't realize the significance of this, but again, look around the country and look what's happening in other places. Kansas City has been a safer place as a result of your donations. And thank you again.